Are we ready, David?
Yep.
Mrs. Gaines?
Here.
Mr. Haynes?
Here.
Mrs. Bowlin?
Here.
Mr. Carlin? Dr. Flowers?
Present.
Mr. Leary?
Yeah.
Ms. Sylvia?
Here.
Stand for the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. If we could pause for a moment of silence for John S. Malikas, 81 of Newport, Rhode Island, who passed away on Tuesday, June 2nd. He was the son of Greek immigrants Stavros and Bessie Malikas. He went to high school at Rogers High School and graduated in 1952. He went on to the University of Arizona on a football scholarship and earned a degree in education. He was the number 3 draft choice of the Chicago Bears in 1956. John played for the Chicago Bears from 56 to 61, San Francisco 49ers from 1992.
62.
62. Where am I? David distracted me. The San Francisco 49ers in 1962 and the Philadelphia Eagles in 1963. After football, he was employed by the Newport School Department as a physical education teacher for 35 years, retiring in 1996. He was an active sports supporter and received numerous awards. John is survived by his wife of 56 years, Martha, his children, Vicki Malikas of Newport, Gia and Peter Harrington of Portsmouth, Sophia and John Troy of Chicago, Illinois, Stavros and Kimberly Malikas of Bristol, Connecticut, and Peter Malikas of Newport. 9 grandchildren, several nieces, nephews, brother and sisters-in-law, and cousins. Thank you. Is there anyone here that would like to make public comment? Okay. Student council update, Catherine.
As another school year comes to a close, June marks big changes for all of us here at Rogers. Over 28 new members of the National Honor Society were inducted a few weeks ago at Rogers. Last Thursday, Rogers held its annual scholarship night, where over $200,000 was awarded to graduating seniors. Over the weekend, the Rogers softball team placed 3rd in their division. The girls had a tremendous season and we're all very proud of them. Tonight, the boys baseball team travels to Burrillville in hopes of winning the opening round match-off of the playoffs. Let's wish our Vikings good luck. Tomorrow night at Ocean Cliff, Rogers will have their senior prom. This Friday at 6 o'clock in the Rogers Auditorium, the class of 2015 will graduate. Please come and show your support for all of our graduates. Tonight will be my last time speaking in front of the school committee as the Rogers student representative. I have thoroughly enjoyed speaking at your meetings, but I'm happy to pass the torch on to the new student council members. Elizabeth Murphy will be the president of the student council next year and speak at the school committee meetings, as I have done. Elizabeth unfortunately cannot be here tonight, but she is very much looking forward to getting to know all of you next year and representing the student body of Rogers High School. Yana Tolich will be the vice president, Sabrina Rainsons will be the secretary, and Julia Downs will be the treasurer. I wish all of you good luck next year. Thank you very much.
And Catherine, we wish you good luck.
We wish you good luck.
You've done a great job. We'll have a little surprise for you Friday night.
Okay. Okay. All right. Thank you, Catherine.
Thank you. Resolutions and certificates, Rhode Island Scholar Athletes. Where are they?
They're here.
They're all here.
All here? Okay. I am so sorry that I missed your banquet on Sunday. I hear it was quite successful, and I think this is the first one I've missed since I've been on the school committee, but I overbooked myself, and things didn't work out as I had planned. Well, I'm still sorry.
Thank you.
Front and center. Get to be the proud mom and school committee member that gets to get up here and give these awards to a bunch of well-deserving juniors who this year the Newport Daily News along with Citizens Bank decided to support and recognize what they call a scholar athlete. And the scholar athlete program is starting this year and it will continue. And what they did was they picked 3 males and 3 females from Rogers High School to represent what they determined was the epitome of highly scholarisms and that's a new word. Yeah, and academia. How's that? So these people excel both in school and they excel on the field. And they're leaders in the school, and Mr. Hanos, that's enough. And so we're very proud of them this year, and we have 4 out of the 6 that were able to make it. And they picked them for different sports, but they represent the school all year long as far as leadership goes. And the first one I'd like to give is to Colin Martin, who's not here. He was chosen for the sport of the swim team. And he was not able to be here tonight. And then the next one is for, we'll make sure he gets it, is for Laquatia M. Logan. You want to come up and get that? And Laquatia received it for her work on the cheerleading team. Okay, next we have Hallie Dugan.
Stay up there.
Yep. And Hallie Dugan, received hers for softball, and we really did a great job. Next, we have Riley Pierce McGinnis Bolin, and he received his for lacrosse. And then we have Mac the Attack Lees, and he received his for hockey. And we want to say that they went to a big banquet that was sponsored up by the Newport Daily News, and they were all got to meet. An ex-Patriot football player named Vince Wilfork, and it was very impressive, and they did a great job representing our school. Keep up the good work, and I know we'll hear great things from you guys when you become seniors next year. Thank you.
Good, so I'll get another chance. Last Saturday, I hope all of you had a chance to go by Pell School sometime during the day. I saw the most fantastic exhibition of STEM activities for young children that I could ever have imagined. And what most impressed me was to see all these little kids everywhere, and nobody was going crazy. They weren't running around doing all kinds of nonsense. They were all engaged in some activity. The 2 people most responsible for that are here tonight. 2 of our very best, Lori DeLemos and Mary Falcone. I meant Lori. Did I say Lori?
You did.
Oh, okay. It's been a long day. I would like to present these on behalf of the school committee. To Mary Falcone, Claiborne Pell Elementary School STEM Specialist, for completing the inaugural year of STEM programming with a successful STEM fair held on Thursday, June 4th, wasn't Saturday, which exposed over 450 students and parents to some of the science inquiry methods and hands-on learning experiences that have been present in our classrooms all year long. Presented this ninth day of June, 2015. Thank you for all your hard work. You want to say anything?
I would just like to say that this wouldn't have been possible without administrative support. We feel like we had the support to bring this program in the direction that we envisioned, and we think it takes a village. Thank you.
Lori, your certificate says the same thing, and it is signed by Kimberly Bean, Colleen Burns, superintendent, Kimberly Bean, principal, and Joe Gaines, school board chair. Thank you very much for all you do for our kids.
Do you mind if I say?
I'd love you to say some.
I did want to thank everyone for coming and supporting us that night. It did take a lot to plan that, and it actually exceeded our expectations. And like she said, there were lots of families and children there, and they were all engaged, and that was my favorite part. So I'm hoping next year that we can do that again.
Who? Oh,
that's
very
right.
Good.
That was great.
Wow.
Yeah,
that's right.
That is great.
No.
So we do have potential vendors already planned, so hopefully it will work out that they will come as well. So, thank you.
Nice job. Thank you.
I think we're going to start doing STEM at our church so kids will stop running around doing mass. Yes.
Madam Chair, we were doing resolutions and certificates, and I just wanted to mention that I was listening very closely to young Catherine. She said the softball girls came out third. They were actually second place this year. They went to the championship. So for the record,
that's great.
I just want to clarify that our girls were second place softball this
All
year.
All right.
Good job.
Good
job.
That's good. Reports from the superintendent.
Thank you, Madam Chair. My reports, all I'm going to say, I'm going to be brief. My reports as presented, I have the updates on how we're doing on your goals for the year. Also, Carrie Clark is, she submitted a school-based coordinator report for this month. She's just, she will be delayed in that because she's actually doing an annual report. So you'll have a comprehensive report at our next meeting. Homeless report, there weren't any significant changes. The enrollment report, you have those in front of you right now. And the last report I think you may want some discussion on is the expenditure and revenues report. If there are any questions, I'll be happy to answer.
Questions? You want a few minutes?
On the revenue report, yes.
David?
No, just a few moments.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's all.
Okay.
Just to look at it.
I just have every. How many students different from last year, this year? You know what the total is? If I could find one, I should know that, but I don't.
You're talking about the total reports.
The total number of students last year we had, and the total number of students we have this year. Mm-hmm. I have to look that up. I should know that.
I can get that for you too.
Yeah. I was curious what the difference is. 2070. Does Joan want to present the budget report to us?
She's
I'm waiting for questions.
Okay, do you gentlemen go up there and present it though? Of course,
sure.
Might as well, I'll go through some of it.
Make that one good for the night, so it's good for us.
I'll look up that number for you now.
Okay, it's hot off the press. It was finished at 1 minute before 4:45.
So what's our projected deficit now? So for the viewing audience, I guess?
$1,070,094. But please note that that includes the transfer from the school capital improvement fund of $220,000 that you authorized last month.
So we might get under the million mark.
We might if the ride busing cooperates.
Yeah.
So anything particularly you want to tell us about, Joan?
We haven't had a chance to look at what's changed.
Well, since we're getting very close to the year end, before when I was leaving the projected alone, if I didn't really know the balance at this point in time, based on the requisitions that I've approved to date, I have solidified some of the savings from all our budget cuts and our lack of spending.
Any other questions? Thank you, John.
You're welcome.
The strategic goals, is there anything you'd like to call our attention to, Superintendent? I'm looking at the first page. Most students opted for the Wednesday after school. Saturday sessions will be revisited next year.
Yes. So as part of our plan to help improve the graduation rate, Chairwoman Gaines is referring to the last box down on the left, establishing the quarterly catch-up Saturday sessions. We did have more students attend the after-school sessions on Wednesdays than we did on Saturdays. We did have a small cohort, though, I do want to let you know, especially for those that were participating in AP classes. They did go to Saturday sessions, and I think they did find them helpful. On the and the graduation rate, we are watching and monitoring that very closely. I actually put in an email today to the counselors, and they're watching very carefully. The counselors are being optimistic. They think a lot of their students, we put in interventions. I don't know if you're aware of that, but we did have after-school sessions, and we did do some extra interventions to help those students that were having some struggles during the last quarter of this year. Everything, the additional AP courses, we're working on those with Mr. Goss. So we do have AP statistics. We have teachers, you'll notice, that are going into training this summer, so we can offer that course for our students. We're continuing our work with Mass Insight to help increase that participation. Mass Insight has been nationally renowned and recognized for its work it did with the Worcester Technical School. And that was actually the place President Obama went to speak to all the students and to the country about education. Our PR campaign for NACTEC, we've been very successful, as you can see by the green. We're providing PD to the NACTEC staff. We had a meeting this afternoon, and we're preparing people for the summer and for next year. We've made a lot of improvements to the facility, and we'll continue that with NACTEC. Tomorrow morning, there's a meeting with the superintendents from the other sending districts, and we'll be going over the Perkins funding for tomorrow. That process, the Perkins funding is allocated, and I believe the allocation did go down. It's federal funds. They're restricted. They can only be used for the career in tech. They're about, I think they dropped to about 216,000 from 222 last year. We use those funds to help support our present career and tech opportunities we have here at our school. And we also, for some of our sending districts, they use a small portion of the funding for school-based coordinators or some possible courses in their schools as well. So we'll have that meeting and discussion tomorrow to go over the funding. And it literally will be a discussion about who gets what. And so we're going to try to settle that politely with each other tomorrow. Let's see, we're exploring different opportunities, and I think the Pell STEM success of this past year, I want to give a special thanks and shout out to Dr. Jay Booth, to Dr. Bean, Kim Bean, the support for these teachers and the staff at Pell School, as well as our community partners, Salve Regina, they were there, Save the Bay. We had quite a few partners there at the fair, so that was a very big success. Most, if you'll know, the good part is our ALP was doing very well, and it has been successful for our students. And our early learning that is on hold right now as far as future site of pre-K. We're in some transition discussions possibly for Hillside Avenue, but I know the fire department just recently went through, and hopefully we'll get a report on that building to see if it is worthy for our pre-K going forward. The truancy, all the committees are in place. We're starting to set procedures and processes. We have data review meetings. As a matter of fact, I have one of those on Thursday with the Van Buren people as far as how we're doing starting up. We're getting baseline data, and we're setting up small focus groups, I believe, in the future. Julie DeBarry is the program evaluator. She's been hired, and she'll be meeting with parents, student groups, etc. STEAM. We continue to make lots of efforts in the area, especially with our Career and Tech Center. We're looking into engineering, and we're looking into marine trades and hospitality. But in the marine trades area in particular, we're trying to increase the technology, the engineering, and the math. We are also submitting a grant. We have two grants that we've just recently submitted, and we'll be submitting a third grant by the end of this week in regards to supporting our career and tech programs. I believe the one we submitted today was a little over $150,000. Budget. We continue to work on the budget as far as research and grants. If you'll notice, we have received additional funds. Our goal was to reach at least two new educational supports. We have received $46,000 from the Aletta Morris McBean Foundation for a van for the NACTAC program. We've received over $18,000 for the STEM program at Pell. We are submitting, as I already mentioned, additional grants. So we're keeping our fingers crossed to get more grants in for our schools. Budget, we are working with, as you know, the city acting city manager and the city finance director on how we can work together going forward as far as accounting, finance, and payroll processes. And we're continuing that work. We're kind of at a little bit of a standstill right now because I think eventually it's going to be a decision by the council and the school committee on how you would like to proceed forward. There has been a suggestion about creating an oversight committee or a group of individuals that would meet on a regular basis as far as reviewing finances. So that's, I think, something for further discussion.
Are there any questions of the superintendent? David?
Two questions, Madam Chair. Thank you. First is the Mass Insight. How much do we pay the Mass Insight? Do we have a contract with them also for the coming school year, or how does that work?
We use funds from our title funds for Mass Insight for professional development supports, and they've been training our teachers at the middle school and the focus in middle school and high school to help with student achievement and just to help support teachers. That contract for this year, I do not believe, has been signed because it's pending funding. We do all contracts pending funding. But I do not believe at this point we have signed that contract. I did receive a request in the past week or so. That's why I'm pretty clear. We have not signed anything. There are some specifics I still needed to review.
We had a contract for them last year?
This year we're in right now. Yes,
okay,
we did.
For the current fiscal year, sorry.
What do we pay them this year?
Off the top of my head, I do not know. I'd have to look that up for you. I'll be happy to get that to you.
But it's title, it's a grant.
It's grant. It's all through our title funds, what the title funds are supposed to be used for, yes.
So it comes into the district from the federal government?
Yes. And it has to be approved by RIDE as well. Anything we put in those.
Does the federal government specifically tell us on its Title I or Title II funds what to spend it on, or do we have discretion? For example, if we say we'd like to spend $1 on Mass Insight, $2 on a teacher, $3 on a microphone, etc.
All of them have parameters, and what I mean by that is, so Title I is specifically, this is where I need a refresher with Dr. Booth. Title I is based on poverty, and it is used for students. It's primarily to be used to support student learning. Title II is to support teacher development and professional development for teachers. So they do have parameters. IDEA, for instance, that's special education. All funding is to be directed towards the support of children with special needs. And Title III is ESL, language assistance, for our students.
And any of the money that is spent is incorporated into our budget, correct?
It is not on the local side, Fund 10, as Joan calls it. It comes out of our federal budget, but it is part of the total bottom line.
Okay, so it's all school committee approved?
It's either school committee or RIDE approved, yes. Because some of them have RIDE approval requirements, if how we use the funding.
But if it's in our budget, it's school committee approved. I should ask it that way. I should ask the question that way.
If the question is, do all the contracts come before the committee? And I think, I don't know, I don't want to put words in your mouth. Is that the question, or?
No, the money that is allocated, if it's allocated by the Newport School Department, is it incorporated in our budget? In other words, is this something that we expend? We are given the money by the federal government, and then we expend it.
Correct.
As a part of our budget process?
Correct.
Or is this something that the federal government says, similar to, for example, federal highway funds, that you can have this money, but you have absolutely no discretion over what is done with this?
So I guess my answer is we don't have any discretion. We can't take Title One and go hire a bunch of teachers.
Okay.
Yeah. And it's restricted. Yeah. It's restricted funds. Yep.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Any other questions? Becky?
You know, I want to know if I could go back and ask Joan just one question, because I will say it is a little difficult. I know she, you know, may have not been able to get to this yesterday, but when you get it right before the meeting.
Right.
So,
sure.
You know, I'm just kind of looking at it on the side as I'm listening. So it's just kind of a general question. When I see that there's 100% left in a fund, like let's say occupational therapy, that's number 53203. And
$750?
Yeah, so I'm just, no, this is just in general. So what I'm saying is when I see there's 100% left, am I to assume that money then, if we don't spend it, which is very likely at this point, that then the bottom line will be reduced by $750?
Correct.
So what I'm looking at, whenever I'm looking at, I saw another one that was physical therapy for $2,500. That's a chance that we're going to be.
Correct. And I did not adjust all of the special education lines because they come in right up to the last.
Okay.
Couple,
but that just
sometimes in July.
But that's very good to know. So there's a very good chance as we whittle this down, that those things have not been counted in. Okay, that was my question.
Good pickup. Any more questions? If If not, we'll move on to the consent. Oh, no, we have to accept these. Is there a motion to accept the reports?
Motion to accept as presented.
Second.
Moved in second. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Okay. Consent agenda. Could I have a motion to approve the consent agenda?
So moved.
Motion to approve.
Is there a second?
I'll second it.
Any discussion?
Yes.
Discuss.
I guess the question is for the superintendent. It looks like there's 47 ESY positions, extended school year. These are summer school?
Yes.
Positions, and these are already budgeted positions?
Yes, and they're required, excuse, for next year's budget, not this year's budget.
But they're in our budget, okay.
Yes, yes.
And this is federal money?
These, no, that's not necessarily true, but just for the audience, extended school year ESY is for students that have been identified through their IEP that will require additional days of instruction, and that will occur after July 1. So we have the meetings in. They can start as, usually they start around April, May, so we have the meetings, we look at how the students are doing, check their achievement, then there's a decision made whether or not the child will require extended school year, which means they go into the summer and they have future, further educational opportunities. Then we have an interview process, people apply, most of the applicants are usually from within our district, and they give the services needed during the summer months.
And these are not necessarily special ed students?
Most of them are special, yes. ESY is mostly special ed students, yes.
But it's not federally funded?
Not necessarily, no.
Okay. Good to know.
There are also out-of-district placements.
Yes.
Okay.
So, Madam Chair?
Yes.
What is the budget for that first? Okay, you take time for that, no problem.
I'm going to say $75,000 just for teachers.
Okay, so that's my, this is my second question. Is there enough kids for all these teachers, or is absenteeism very high in the summer?
Oh, no, there's enough students for these teachers, and the absenteeism is not, no, we don't have an absentee.
Is that a problem?
No. Usually families are looking for these services.
Good question.
Any other questions?
Any other questions?
Yeah. Madam Chair?
Yes.
The asterisk next to a individual's name indicates the pending verification of references and second interview with the superintendent. What's the discretion there, or I should say, what's the discretion? What's the difference? How many need verification of references, and how many need to go through a second interview with you? If it's a second interview, how come?
I like to meet all teachers that work in our district.
Yeah.
So I've put a practice in that I meet with all of them, and they will come meet with me between tomorrow and Friday. So unless there's something that's unusual, I would come back or I would halt, you know, say, I want to pause and I want to go back to the school committee. But 99% of the time, they all do fine.
So, for example, there are several with asterisks next to their names. What's the plan for... You said 99% of the time. So we'll just say that likely everyone is coming in.
They have to come in.
I see a couple of names on there, several names on there, that, you know, they've been with the system for many, many years.
Right.
I'm assuming that they simply haven't had a second interview with you?
Yes, I meet with all of them.
All right, so has everyone had a first interview?
No, they've all passed the screening with the teams, yeah. And they've been with the interview teams, Alin, sometimes the building principals, they've all passed. And what I usually do is I meet with them prior to the meeting. Sometimes, as in this case, the interviews finished, I believe, on Thursday or Friday of last week.
Yeah.
and there wasn't enough time to bring them all in, so we always make I always make sure I meet with everyone, so that's why the asterisks are there.
So it's not necessarily a second interview. It could be a first interview.
No, they're all seconds. They've all been through the committees.
I'm sorry.
Interview committees.
And second interview with the superintendent. So it's a second interview, but a first interview with you.
Yes.
Okay, because they've been through a first interview with someone else. There are some names on here also who have received layoff notices. Does that come into consideration at all? Is that a problem? Is that an issue?
No, it's not a problem.
No.
They want to work during the summer.
So, in other words, if you've lost your position with the Newport School Department, but yet you come back in the summertime,
mm-hmm.
that does not affect the district in any way in terms of the notice that we've given to that particular individual.
That is correct. I'm not calling them back to the position they were laid off.
Gotcha. Yeah. Great. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Any further questions? Could I have a motion to accept the personnel the consent agenda?
So moved.
Second. It's moved in second. Further discussion? Hearing none. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Okay. Action items. Rogers High School's senior class request for support for the 26th annual post-graduation party. I gather they are looking for a donation.
Yes, it looks like they're looking for a $1,000 donation.
Is there a motion here?
So moved.
I don't think it needs any explanation. Is there a second?
Second.
It's been moved in second. Discussion. Any questions on the post-graduation party?
Bobby has something.
Yeah, I don't have a question. I just want to know that we've done this in the past. This is not new.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Every year.
Yeah. Since they instituted it, right. They've supported it.
Is there a line item discretionary fund for that? Or are they looking for
We'll probably take it out of the superintendent's contingency fund. I don't know.
Really?
I'm only kidding.
I didn't know I had one.
I'm only kidding. Joan, where will
we?
Okay.
Yeah, as we say.
We don't have one either.
No, we have our monthly
So
checks.
Where will we take this? Where will we get the $1,000?
Out of the deficit.
All right. I'll go for that.
Oh, we'll go.
This is a very important activity. It saves lives. We know where our kids are. They are safe. They are at an alcohol-free party. We don't have to worry about boozing in the back seat. So I would support it. If it means more to the deficit, so be it. Any other comments?
Madam Chair,
yes.
It's a wonderful event, and I've supported it as all of us have supported it.
Mm.
I didn't realize it would add to the deficit, however. That's a bad signal. I mean, I'll raise the $1,000 if need be personally and make that commitment rather than put us in a situation where we add to the deficit and insult the council. I know the council won't be insulted by the underlying but, you know, we've got a budget. We should live by the budget. I'll probably vote for it anyway. But, I mean, my point is, I mean, we can't just be willy-nilly about our budget. I mean, this is,
it's not.
It gets ridiculous at some point.
I hear what you're saying. And I think all of us individually contribute to this.
Of course we do, absolutely.
The council members will, too.
And the council is getting the same letter. So
the council has hundreds of thousands of dollars to spare.
Yes.
Maybe we could, you know, so that this doesn't come up at the end of each year, we could next year add this under, you know, for an additional $1,000 and put it under the graduation supplies line or graduation.
Excellent point.
So
that's what I would suggest.
There's some left in the honors
and
awards. Yeah. Is that still
take a note.
Or graduation supplies. Mm-hmm. It could also be just graduation. Yeah.
Okay.
Well, is there anything left? We could almost make that part of the motion. to next year.
No, you can add it, make another motion if you want. All in favor of the motion to support the annual post-graduation party by donating $1,000, raise your hand. No opposition? Oh, okay, it's unanimous. Becky, did you want to make another motion?
If this were to be appropriate, my motion would be to add $1,000, and I've got my eyes off that line right now, the graduation supply line, which is...
I have to look up the UCOA number.
I just saw it. We have, it still has $1,400 left in it because we haven't touched it yet. That's the only reason. I just saw it.
Oh, is it? Oh.
So...
Touch it now.
Don't touch it.
No, you got to pay. You got to pay for the diplomas.
Right. So anyway, my motion is to add $1,400 to the graduation
And I'm just saying that may not be the proper UCOA line.
Okay, if it's...
Or a donation by the school committee.
So would you please add in $1,000 in an appropriate line for next year's budget?
Is there a second? Moving second. Discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? It's unanimous. Okay, we can move on to the next. Approval of the 2015-16 NACTEC tuition rates.
What are they?
They're not posted.
I don't have them.
I'm gonna request that we table this, and I'll send it out at the next week
Move
meeting.
To table.
Thank you.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 Opposed? Okay. Shared services oversight. This is something that the city and the school committee has been working on for 3 years.
10 years. 2005 was the first time it was Berkshire Report.
Yeah, you're right. You're right. It goes all the way back to that. And this year, I think we made a gigantic leap forward. And I have to credit the superintendent and Joan for their willingness to travel to City Hall 2 or 3 times a week to listen to the council and the school committee. Intention to collaborate with the city wherever we possibly could in order to, one, improve the relationships between the two bodies, and three, to better serve the citizens and the kids of Newport. I think we're knocking on the door. There will be a joint resolution. We are asked to pass something tonight. The council will talk about it tomorrow. They might do a little editing, a little switching around. But the concept of working together for transparency, for better understanding of how it works on both sides of the aisle here, not Republican, Democrat, council and city council. So Bobby has some words. I have some input from other council members. He has input from some council members. We need to decide on the first resolution. I'm saying the first because there'll probably be some editing between us and the council.
So, Madam Chair, we want some generic comments before we make the motion.
Absolutely.
First? All right. So, I think for the viewing public has to know that we made decisions this year, past school committee, made decisions to spend money. Excuse me, my voice is going. We did not have, expecting that we would get some line item savings that didn't all come through. And there was a lot of risk. It came with those decisions that we made, or past school committee made. And the city council's not upset because they feel like we have a contract with us when they give us our budget. They have a budget, you live in your budget, and we kind of broke the contract. And what they want is that going forward, is that if you're going to take a risk like that, they want to be involved. They want to know you did something, we didn't tell them. So basically, this resolution is to hopefully prevent doing what happened in this year going forward again. That's the main point of the resolution I hear from most people. But I don't want to tie up conversation. Let people from general comments, and I'll make the motion and go from there.
Why don't you, do we want the motion or make a motion.
Okay, so,
Read what you have.
Okay, so if everybody would take out the motion that has the long one, the ones that's given to us tonight, this one here is like seven motions. Everybody have that one?
Yeah.
Well, okay. Diagonally.
Right, goes yeah. like this?
The diagonal.
Right. So that, if you would, if you take that one out, the first 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 paragraphs are fine. Does anybody have any, and I'll make the motion, make the motion, right, Mrs. Gaines. The middle one where it says, so be resolved, if you X that out, where it says, so be resolved, the City Council, Newport School Committee, that one there, X that out, and insert this. I'm sorry I don't have, it's been going on all day, conversation, so if you insert this, so be it.
Not yet.
Okay.
You have the three, the two that stay. The two short one sentence
right.
paragraphs.
Just that one paragraph coming out.
Right.
And in that place you put this. That's what I want to say.
Okay, go
no, in that place I'm going to give you a comment. Okay. We're supposed to go in there. Okay, so in that place would say, so be it resolved that the city finance director will provide full oversight and direction to the school department's accounting and procurement budgeting, but not limited to accounting and budgeting.
Okay.
So that's the only line in there. Everything else
I'll move that for discussion.
Right, exactly.
I'll second it for discussion.
Point of order, Madam Chair.
Yeah.
What's the action item in front of us?
What he just read.
A resolution.
Would be
this.
Okay.
The rest of it stays
okay.
So is it?
Do you want?
So be it resolved.
You want to read the language again?
So be resolved.
We have two pieces of language that we are going to have to decide on.
Right.
What Bobby is reading to you is language that he got from a council member.
Oh. Right, so it starts with, whereas the Newport City Council and the Newport School Committee understand and realize.
Yes.
And it goes all the way down to effective July 1st, 2015.
Minus that.
Okay.
All right.
Take out the first, so be it resolved.
All right. So we're going to officially amend the action item then. So.
No, we're not
amending. I'm sorry. We're going to amend this.
We are determining.
Making a.
The action item. We are going to pass a resolution. We have to determine the wording of the resolution.
Okay. So what, again, what is before us? Is it this full resolution?
Minus that.
But if it's minus that, then why is that before us?
That
will be amended, correct?
This is language.
Yes.
This is language that we are deciding on.
Right.
Just say yes.
Okay.
We're deciding as we go along.
You know my reasoning.
No, I don't.
I like to follow what should be the order of business. I see an entire item in front of us, and I appreciate that. So are we going to move that item, second it, then discuss it, and amend that item?
No.
We are not.
What you see in front of you is language that we will use in the eventual resolution that we pass. It is up to us to use this language or not. Bobby and I are suggesting that this paragraph, so be it resolved that Newport City Council, etc., in the middle of the page, not be in consideration.
Okay, so we'll amend it then.
So, Madam
Chair. Wait, 1 minute.
That's fine.
One
amend what's in front of us. You want to do that, Dave? I don't have a problem with that. We can amend what's in front of us. That's the problem with that.
Yeah.
Amending what's in front of us. Okay.
Kathy?
So, Madam Chair, my question, we're taking out that paragraph, and then he would like the city finance director.
Yeah, Bobby has some other language.
To direct. Full oversight.
Then he has to dictate.
You said oversight and direction.
Oversight and direction to the school department's accounting and procurement budgeting.
Okay.
So therefore, she would have authority over the superintendent.
Well,
No.
Well, that's what we're, I'm not sure of.
Yeah, no.
That's why I'm going to read you another paragraph.
Right.
That we might want to substitute for that language.
It's going to be difficult, and the model council will do the same thing, I understand.
And that, this language is the, next to the last, well, it's the last paragraph before the final so be it resolved.
No, there's no attempt to have control of the superintendent, I can tell you that for a fact.
And this, this language, and combine all purchasing functions under the city purchasing agent, as well as realigning the payroll processes to better meet the needs of the city finance director as the school superintendent, working with the administrative services and business manager, ensures that school employees change or adapt current processes to conform to the city's purchasing policies and procedures to better streamline operations and resources of time, personnel, and money. The city purchasing agent will familiarize herself or himself with school requirements, ordinances, and any applicable ride requirements. I think that letter, that language is more descriptive of what we are trying to do. It tells you point blank what we will be doing. It gives us the reasons for doing it, and it doesn't leave anything to the imagination. So Bobby's motion includes the language that he received from a councilman. This is what we received from most of the councilmen, agreed with this that I spoke to, as well as city staff and our people.
There was a third one.
Number five, that the accounting and payroll processes.
Number five what?
On the
back of this. This one.
It's a different one.
The back.
That's
the back of that one.
You got that?
Oh, on this other one.
You don't have this?
I think it's almost at a point we might want to table this thing.
No.
I know.
We promised something tonight.
There's somebody's words.
Julie, you know what, Ms. Gaines, maybe what we do is go back to the, you know, like, they're the ones that seem to be really into the specific language. It's real, we, could we pass this in concept and ask them to just work on the wording?
That's exactly what I think we should do.
Just pass the, you know, in concept and ask them to come back. Because I think they want to know tomorrow night that we're supporting what they're trying to help us do. And so, but the exact wording is going to be very difficult, you know.
And they are going to have a stab at the wording.
Right.
But I think the concept is great. I suggested that. But I think they want something in front of them that we've delivered.
And almost say take both of these and you guys combine it and fix it and send it back.
It's too hard to fix it without anything writing in front of you.
It's too hard to fix it.
That's what will be implemented.
Could we somehow in concept say we absolutely are in agreement, you know, with...
With what one?
With what?
Yeah.
Which one is five of them?
I think we can make that decision tonight, Becky.
You think we can get to it? It's going to be hard.
Yeah, I really do.
The paragraph that was deleted. And then there were two smaller ones after. Are those remaining in?
Yes.
Okay.
And the one we're discussing is the third one that I read.
And combined.
And Bobby's like, Bobby, read yours again.
It's not mine, but yes. So be resolved that the city finance director will provide full oversight and direction to the school department's accounting and procurement budgeting.
It's not specific.
What's, Madam Chair, what's before us? I have no idea. I mean, we have no, I moved the table.
No, we can't.
No, we've promised this, we would start this process by passing a resolution.
Well, I have a motion on the floor, so just reject my motion that I moved the table.
I'll second the motion to table it at this point.
Yes, please. Do we vote on that?
Yeah, it's non-debatable, though.
Okay, all in favor of tabling? All opposed? Motion to table denied.
Madam Chair.
Wait a minute. The school superintendent's going to speak, and then we'll...
All right, so I can just share what I know of these two documents. Both documents are documents that, from the school department perspective, as written, the school department supports and is, and it comes out of the discussions we've had with Acting City Manager Joe Nicholson and City Finance Director Laura Citron. We're both, and Joan and I have seen these, and we feel they're very doable, and it's a great step in the direction of collaborating with the city and becoming one city, united, working together for the good and best of all our citizens, and especially schools' children, but most importantly of all, we're one Newport. And we want to work together to make Newport the community for all of us. The one with the confidential that has straight across, number 5, is very recent language that the acting city manager and I reviewed last evening together. And it was a compromise in another document I had seen at another time, because at that point in time, there was language in it that did say under the direction, and I did wonder about keeping the two institutions separate, and it did make me wonder if someone from the school department is under the direction of someone at the city, where is the division? Mm-hmm. And that is why you'll notice on that fifth one, it says supported by the superintendent. Is that kind of wording is in there. So in that way, I feel it allows and it enables, as always, for the school department to hold the superintendent accountable to make certain these actions are carried out. And at the same time, I think it gives, for the council, it gives them the opening of the door to speak with the committee about if the superintendent, if he or she is not following up and following the practices we agreed we would do. So that is why that kind of language was put in there. I felt if you didn't have that connection and that oversight on the school department side, then you could very easily, if someone isn't reporting to another institution, they don't have to do what you say you want them to do. So that's why that's put in there.
Kathy's next, and then Sandra.
I'm all set.
No, the paragraph that was deleted, that more or less is the method by which this will be carried out. Is that why you...
There was some objection from several of the council members to creating another committee.
Okay.
They felt that a lot of the work that's been done toward this effort mm-hmm. was done at the liaison committee.
Yeah.
And that they could authorize the liaison committee mm-hmm. to be this financial oversight committee, because it's three councilmen and three school committee people who meet.
Okay, I just wanted to clarify that. And then also there's a line, and I think the superintendent just mentioned about, you know, the supported by the superintendent of schools, and then the following line about sort of underscoring that governmental responsibilities that are specific to this side always doesn't
stay with the side, right?
Reinforce that, shall we say.
So that's what we have before us.
Good.
David, you're scratching. What?
I'll ask for the resolution to be read before we take a vote, but I mean, there have been so many verbal amendments to this that I'd like to have the resolution read back to us.
Bobby, would it be appropriate for me to offer an amendment to what you read.
Whatever the floor thing is, what's Parliament's decision then?
Kathy's our parliamentarian.
Well, Bobby's motion's on the floor, right?
Yeah. And the only difference is that sentence that he had from one council person and the one that we're looking at here on this page.
So why does he, if the cleaner way would be for him to withdraw it, if he's willing to.
And because he promised that person to present it. So
He wants his motion intact, so it should be voted on.
Okay, the only thing I will say is that the only difference in Bobby's motion and the motion that would follow is, if his is not passed, would be the substitution of this language, the last paragraph from the last sentence, would be substituted. The language that we see as more descriptive.
I have a problem with that language.
Yes.
Okay, so Bobby, because I couldn't even write fast enough, but...
I know. It's almost like table. I was going to table it, but we're not table.
But the budget, the word budget really shouldn't be in there, I don't think. You got the word budget in there. That has to remain a function of the school committee completely. I mean, I think by law...
So we need to vote on this motion.
Budgeting.
It's budgeting.
Procurement of budgeting.
And accounting.
Right.
Oh, not budget, budgeting.
Oh, budgeting. And yeah. Okay, so I said it's
the same difference.
So it says, so it be resolved that the city finance director will provide full oversight and direction to the school department's accounting and procurement budgeting.
That direction is the problem. Okay. Can I call the motion?
Call the motion.
You have a comment.
It's a comment on Mr. Lee. That is a motion that right now we are having a discussion on.
That was first and second, as Kathy said. Yeah.
I have a problem with direction. I'm against the word direction because it implies, or it actually is quite literally, we will be and shall be directed by someone other than a governing body, which is elected to run the school department's budget, or basically. So I would vote no on that particular line item, Mr. Leary, because I just don't like the word under direction of somebody else. I don't mind the oversight issue. I clearly understand the collaboration. I realize that Joan is also in agreement that there could be collaboration with the processing of accounting and payroll, but I do not like the word the words under direction of. I don't agree with that.
Call the vote on it.
Okay, I'll move the question.
The question has been moved. Okay.
Discussion-wise, Madam Chair, I'm extremely disappointed that, you know, on board docs this evening we had a vague description of what was happening. It's the first time I've seen any of this in writing. I have no idea what we're voting on. I don't see it in front of me. I can't remember the things that were dictated orally, and I don't think anyone else can. As Becky said, you know, Bob was going way too fast, not because he wanted to, just because circumstances exist. We should actually see something in front of us in writing, and we probably should see, in fact, I believe we should see it in writing much, much before the beginning of a school committee meeting. If we're going to vote on something as significant as this, I'm extremely disappointed in the process.
Okay. There was a motion to move the question.
Yes.
All in favor of the resolution as read by Bobby, please raise your hand. Okay. All opposed? Okay, same resolution with a different last line. Should I read the entire thing?
Please.
Okay. Well,
what last line?
We're looking at the one with the diagonal confidential.
Yes, with the diagonal copy.
And the first five whereases are the same?
Okay.
Whereas the Newport City Council and the Newport School Committee understand and realize the importance of a quality education for all children and its responsibility to support efforts to ensure the delivery of such. And whereas the Newport City Council and the Newport School Committee want to provide its citizenry a free and appropriate education to enable Newport families' children future access to college and career opportunities to become productive and contributing members to our community. And whereas the Newport City Council and the Newport School Committee understand the importance and value a quality educational system is for the community, its health and well-being, as well as future economic development for its city. And whereas the Newport City Council and Newport School Committee seek to work together to provide quality educational opportunities for all Newport children to realize these results. And whereas the Newport City Council and Newport School Committee wish to combine its efforts and energies to fund schools effectively, responsibly, and fiscally appropriately, as well as share services by consolidating the technology services of the city and school departments to provide more efficient and cost-saving practices through outsourcing oversight of systems, and share services by combining their facilities maintenance under a city-employed facilities manager that will work with the superintendent to facilitate building safety, cleanliness, and management and operations, and combine all purchasing functions under the city purchasing agent, as well as realign the payroll processes to better meet the needs of the city finance director as the superintendent, working with the administrative services and business manager, ensures that school employees change or adapt current processes to conform to the city's purchasing policies and procedures to better streamline operations and resources of time, personnel, and money. The city purchasing agent will familiarize her or himself with school requirements, ordinances, and any applicable RIDE requirements. So be it resolved by the City Council and Newport School Committee that this resolution will be effective July 1st, 2015.
Madam Chair, thank you very much for that.
Paragraph 5.
Paragraph 5.
Which one?
On the next page, the other resolution.
You have to add that to it.
You have to add that the accounting and payroll process.
That's what you were going to do.
That's what I read.
No. This one.
You wanted to add that.
No, that's the one that there was a problem.
Because you already have said
That's the one added? That's the one to be added that Colleen and Joe worked on.
Oh, I'm sorry. I remember now. So where did we add it? At the end?
There needs to be a correction. Wait a minute.
Wait a minute.
We crossed out a paragraph right after, whereas the Newport City Council and School Committee wish to combine its efforts, it should be, therefore, be it resolved.
Yes. What are we adding? What are we adding?
Okay.
And then you could put the Council and School Committee will share services by consolidating technology. That would become one.
Oh, you, wait, now you're editing. Let's just get the language.
Well, because you didn't do a be it resolved.
She's adding a be it resolved from the paragraph that got eliminated.
So should number 5 be it resolved?
No.
3. Number 5 will become number 4.
We got it. 5 will become number 4.
Right.
Paragraph number 4?
Yeah, 1 will be that they'll share services, two combined facilities, three combined purchasing. Four will be accounting and payroll processes.
And five's going to be...
And then you could have as five that this resolution will take effect.
Kathy, I lost it. Can you explain? I hate to be...
Yeah, do it again.
I lost it.
Don't read the whole thing.
Don't read it, yeah. Where are we at? So let me speak this way.
After the five whereas's.
One, two, three, four, five. The first five are fine, right?
Yep.
Yes.
Then we'll keep in just the four words, so be it resolved.
Yep.
And jump down to, instead of as well as, put... You put...
Or seven.
Be it resolved.
Be it resolved, and then put, instead of as well as share services, you'll put the Newport City Council and School Committee
will
share services.
Yeah, that's, yeah.
By consolidating technology, et cetera. Number two will become and share services by combining the facilities maintenance. Number three will be, will combine all purchasing functions, et cetera. Number four will be, the accounting and payroll processes of the school department will be implemented, et cetera.
Yep.
And then you could have, and be it resolved that the Newport City Council and School...
Okay, so the only part I did not read was...
The accounting.
That the accounting and payroll processes of the school department will be implemented per the direction of the city finance director and supported by the superintendent of schools. All governmental responsibilities of the school superintendent and school committee, as otherwise described in state law, will remain completely intact.
Correct.
That's it.
Colleen, did you understand when...
Is it a motion?
Okay.
Yeah. That was the motion.
Second?
That was the motion. Okay.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded. Any discussion?
Yeah, I have some discussion.
Okay.
I'm a little first of all, I'm going to be voting against this one now. I'm a little confused. I think it needs to be in front of me, but I never thought I'd be saying that. And sometimes in life, you don't want to vote the way you want to vote. I never thought I'd vote against shared services, but since we've had, in 2005, the Berkshire Report recommended this. Mm-hmm. And then we had the LGD&C report done, and they recommended combining business office stuff. And then we had the finance, we had Lois Citrin's audit review the whole place. And then we had financial committee report in 2014. And now you had a vote by the voters saying in 2014 that they should combine question number nine, was that? I forget what number question. But let's see, but it was...
Question. The city council can combine city council any departments.
What's that?
Wasn't the city council
right? And it passed 70-40. So everybody's saying do this, and now I got to say no, because first of all, I'm confused with what's in front of me, and second of all, they haven't explained how they're going to do the technology and the maintenance yet. Is there a way they're going to do this?
They're already working at it.
Right? So it's the technology director will be doing this stuff over?
No, they have outsourced it.
Yeah, go ahead.
That's the contract we've been discussing. I've brought up before that we're going to use the same contractor for both the school department and the city, and we'll outsource that just as the city is doing now.
So who pays for the outsourcing? The city is.
We did not come to the final dollars and cents to your question. They're outsourcing.
So
we're trying to get. We're trying. Wait a minute. No, just for the technology. And the thinking is, and we've already had preliminary discussions with the contractor, that they'll lower the prices so it'll give a better price for the contract with the city and the schools.
Sandra?
Just one little thing. That paragraph where it has, when combine all purchasing functions. And it says how the purchasing agent would familiarize with school requirements. And we have the word ordinances. We have policies, not ordinances.
Yeah, but we're combining. We have to observe their policies.
The school requirements.
Ordinances and policies.
We don't have ordinances. We don't really have ordinances. The city does. We have policies. Maybe I'm just being...
Well, yeah, I think...
I'm being a wonk, I'm sorry.
There are ordinances in the city.
Definitely.
I wouldn't
Oh, see, I read that as part of the school side of things.
Aren't there ordinances in the charter that refer to the schools?
Yeah, this is,
yes.
No. Okay.
Like our compensation is an ordinance of the council.
I was just being a wonk.
Okay, so Mr. Leary, I think, also asked about facilities.
Yes.
And we've started to have that discussion with the facilities and the city, and Bill Riccio is already helping us with the RHS roof project, but the city will be hiring someone, and they will take on that cost, and then that person will work for the schools as well.
Becky, did you know? Any further questions?
No.
Oh, wait a minute. I'm sorry.
I lost my train of thought.
I'm sorry.
It's hard. All stuff written down here, believe me. I've been there. I've got so much stuff here now.
I know what I was going to say. My understanding is, in this resolution that tonight, this is a work in progress that you want to share with the city council?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yes.
I just wanted to clarify that. So, in other words, I could see, to some people's points, there might be some language changes to make it run smoother.
I think the
intent in this resolution is to say we do want to work together collaboratively, and we do also understand the need for the city side as far as the accounting and payroll processes and the purchase and the accounts payable as well. So we understand all that. Both documents, as I said earlier, recognize and exemplify the discussions what we have in our small group, in our meetings, have agreed would work well going forward. But it's for you and the council to decide. Thank you.
And it also reflects the work of the liaison committees. And I have to say, the a very strong influence for this moving forward with this effort to collaborate came about as a result of that finance, what was it called, Ken? The Finance Review Committee. And they have attended every single liaison committee. Their advice is constant and reliable
and helpful.
And I think they agree that this is a necessary step. If we are really to move this system forward, we've got to have the support and the cooperation of the council.
So, Madam Chair, are we actually adopting the resolution or just the concept?
Well, both. Because we are, by adopting this resolution, sending it forward to the council, we're sending the message that we're ready to collaborate.
Okay.
They might have some language.
Right.
Stuff to do. If so, that would come back to us.
Okay. A little technical.
Yes.
Can we make families plural with an S apostrophe?
Yes. Okay. Yeah. I'll work with you tomorrow.
Which grammatical?
Okay.
Which one?
Is 15? Well,
family should have an apostrophe.
Plural
if
families.
I was referring to the different things, the Berkshire Report and the LGD's board, but I guess the council wants to work collaboratively, because if you read the last election, 2014, question 15, it says, notwithstanding any other provision of this chapter to the contrary, the city council shall have the authority to merge common duties, functions, and or services of any agency or department of the city in another department or agency of the city, including but not limited to any department or agency established by or enumerated in this charter or by the Constitution and state laws. And that passed 70% to 30% by the voters.
So we're doing the voters' bidding.
So we're going to vote now?
Yeah, are you ready to vote?
Just a quick point, Madam Chair. As I read this, and I hope I'm getting the language the correct way, what we're essentially doing here, and I know collaboration is the intent, and I appreciate and respect that, and I support that. And I also support the council's willingness to work with us on a financial level and also on an indirect financial level, like taking over some of the long-term construction needs, etc. But what we're doing here is we are relinquishing, in my opinion, this is my opinion, we're relinquishing what is a school committee and a school department duty. Right. We're saying here we're going to combine all purchasing functions under the city purchasing agent so that we're taking the purchasing out of our hands, and we're going to give it to the purchasing agent.
No.
And we're realigning the payroll process to better meet the needs of the city finance director. So, I mean, we may agree to disagree, but I think the wording's pretty clear. And we are sharing services by combining the facilities maintenance under a city-employed facilities manager. So, again, we're turning that over to the city. If that's the will of the committee, so be it. But why not turn the whole thing over to them? I mean, we can't, by state law, we can't turn the superintendent's office over to the city. That's dictated by state law. But just about everything else is at our discretion. Yeah, we're turning everything over to them. We're turning many of the functions over to the city council. For whatever reason we say, why not go further? I mean, I say to you, my colleagues, that we are turning over some of our responsibilities tonight. If that is your will, so be it. I will vote against it. Thank you.
Any further discussion? Marson?
Who made the motion?
I moved it. Who seconded it? We had a lot of seconds.
I can take responsibility.
Yeah.
Yeah. We both said it, I think.
Yeah. Okay. May I ask one question?
Yes.
Of, I don't think it's on.
It's on. Oh. It's on.
The superintendent.
Yes.
Are you comfortable?
Yes.
With the resolution?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, are we ready to vote? All in favor of the resolution as read and edited?
Aye.
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 Opposed?
Aye.
The vote is 5-2. The motion passes. So the superintendent and our editors over there will work on cleaning this up for presentation to the council.
Okay.
So they can read it tomorrow night.
Yeah, I know.
And if they have any feedback, we'll be back.
Can I make a comment?
Yes.
It was a lot of back and forth. You know, when you're working with basically, I mean, the seven of us plus the super, you know, so you got eight on this side, eight on the other side. It's a very difficult process to get through. And we just wanted to, I think the intention was to have something accomplished by tomorrow night to show that we're all on the same page, you know, or both groups are. So there were a lot of renditions that went back and forth today. It was a difficult day, and I know Mr. Leary spent a lot of time trying to get it right. And you know, you agree with a lot of this, but just the wording isn't right for you, I think, you know, exactly. So, but I do appreciate what he went through and
yep.
Mrs. Gaines and the city council to try to get it done.
Mm-hmm. Well, we made the first step.
Mm-hmm.
I guess that was the last item. We have a meeting on the Thursday?
No, there's just to alert all of you, there's a meeting posted for Thursday if needed. And our next meeting is next Tuesday at 4:45 for budget.
No council 94 this week?
We have executive
That's
session.
Negotiations.
You want to go into executive
week? No, not tonight. Next week.
Yes.
On the 11th?
Okay.
Yeah.
Just let us know why we're going in.
It's negotiations.
Okay.
And
I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
Okay. I was getting scared there for a minute. All in favor?
Thank you.